गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लास व्हाट वी लर्न अबाउट एंगल. ओके, व्हाट इज कॉल्ड एन एंगल चिल्ड्रन? सो द एंगल इज फॉर्म्ड एट कॉमन पॉइंट. द एंगल इज फॉर्म्ड एट कॉमन पॉइंट ऑफ टू लाइन सेगमेंट The angle is formed at common point of two line segments. Is it possible for two rays, children? Yes, it is also possible for two rays also. Okay. So how is it formed angle? Suppose I have to draw two line segments. This is A, this is B. Another line segment I have to draw here. This is C. Okay. Now we have these two line segments formed at common point. They are joined at common point. What is that common point here? A. What is the common point here? A. What do you call that one? You can call that one as vertex. What do you call this one? Vertex. Vertex is nothing but corner. So where it is angle formed? Here it will form angle. Okay. Here it is formed at angle. Okay, ma'am. And what do you call this one? AB and AC. What do you call arms of the angle? So what do you call AB and AC? What do you call these two? Arms of the angle. Arms of the angle. And what is the symbol of an angle? What is the symbol? You should write like this. This is the symbol of angle. And what is the name of this angle? How to name this angle? You can name as C, B A C or C A B. Angle C A B or angle B A C. You should write the vertex in the middle only. You should always written vertex as middle only. Okay, children, vertex always should write in the middle only. So how to read this angle? Angle C A B or angle B A C. Okay, children, did you understand? This is about yesterday's class. Now we are going to the next topic: angles, types of angles. Open your studio, all of you. Open your studio. Page number 20. Identify the sides of the rectangular door that form angles. See here, one rectangular door is given. So like this door is given. Okay. Rays allow them to draw rays. You can draw the rays on that where the angles form. Where it is? See here one example given. Like this rays drawn here. It will form an angle or not? Yes, it forms an angle. Here also, it forms an angle. And here also, forms an angle. And here also, forms an angle. All of you draw in your textbook studio. So it is already given. You should draw like this. At three corners, you should draw like this. Okay. Does these rays form angles? It forms an angle or not? Yes. Why? Because two line segments formed at common point. So it forms an angle. Two line segments join at common point. So it forms an angle. Okay. So you should tick here. Yes. What can you say about this angle? What can you say about this angle? Here, see, horizontal ray, vertical ray. Okay, horizontal ray, this one, and this is vertical ray. It forms an angle like this. It forms an angle. What do you call this angle, children? Which type of angle this one? Right angle. What do you call? Right angle. Right. Angle. Okay. Right angle. You should write here. Right angle. What can you say about this angle? Is right angle. So in activity 2.4, the horizontal and vertical rays meet at a common point. The horizontal and vertical rays meet at a common point. Okay, it forms an angle. Horizontal rays and vertical rays meet at common point. It forms an angle. This angle is called right angle. This angle is called right angle. So how to draw right angle, students? Straightly like this. Okay. Horizontal ray and it is vertical ray. It forms a right angle. Okay. And next, another one. It will also form right angle. Okay. And next. It will also form right angle. It will also form right angle. So straight line. Horizontal rays and vertical rays meet at a common point. It forms a right angle. Okay, horizontal rays and vertical rays meet at a common point. It forms a right angle. Okay, children, did you understand now? Come on, draw on your studio this angle and write in the blank right angle. Next, see in studio, page number 20, identify and mark right angles in the given images. So here, some images are given here, okay? You should identify the right angles. See here, at the corners you should write like this rays. This is right angle or not? Yes. Okay, you should find out right angles. Mark right angles here. And is it possible for circle right angle? Is it possible, children? No. Okay. So for these three only, it forms a right angle. Okay. Next. You can do at home. Next one, see hands-on activity. All of you do with me, along with me. Take your right hand. Fold like this. Take your right hand, fold like this. Okay? Straightly. So, see here, I fold this arm like this. Now, I'm opening like this. Okay? Now, see here, this is a horizontal and this is vertical. So, which angle it is formed? It is a right angle. Okay. So here in the studio, see, the angle formed is a dash angle. Which angle it is? It is a horizontal, it is vertical. So which angle it is? Right angle. Right here, right. R-I-G-H-T, right. Okay. Next. Take your right hand. Now, see here, this is a right angle. Okay. Now, I am moving this hand to right side like that. Now, is it smaller than right angle or equal to right angle or greater than right angle, children? Come on, observe. It is a smaller than right angle or equal to right angle or greater than right angle. It is a greater than right angle. Okay, ma'am. So, here, see, in studio, the angle formed is smaller than a right angle, equal to a right angle, bigger than a right angle. It is a bigger than a right angle. So you have to tick here, bigger than a right angle. Okay. Now I am closing to hand, this arm. So which angle it is? it is smaller than right angle or equal to right angle or greater than right angle, children? It is? Yes, it is smaller than right angle. So here, the angle formed is smaller than a right angle, equal to a right angle, bigger than a right angle. Yes, it is a smaller than a right angle. So tick here, smaller than a right angle. Smaller than a right angle. Okay, children. So what is called this angle? It is a horizontal, this is a vertical. So which angle it is formed here? Right angle. Now I am moving this hand to arm. So it is smaller than right angle. It is smaller than right angle. So what do you call this when such these angles are called? Acute angles. Okay. If the angle is smaller than right angle is called acute angles. What is called ma? Acute angle. Smaller than right angle is called acute angle. So smaller than right angle is called acute angle. Okay, ma'am. Next one. Now I'm moving the hand to right side. Now it is equal to right angle or smaller than right angle or bigger than right angle, children? Yes, it is bigger than right angle. Okay, ma'am. So what do you call this angle? This angle is called obtuse angle. What do you call this angle? Obtuse angle. So bigger than right angle. Bigger than right angle is called obtuse angle. So bigger than right angle is called obtuse angle. Smaller than right angle is called acute angle. Bigger than right angle is called obtuse angle. Now I am keeping the hand like this, straightly. Okay, this is one line segment, this is another line segment. So both are joined here, this point. Both are having common point. Now it forms an angle or not? Yes, it forms an angle. So which angle is this? This is like a straight. So what do you call this angle? Straight angle. What do you call this angle? Straight angle. Straight angle. Okay, ma'am. So this is a straight, no? That's why it is a straight angle. Now what do you learn here? Now children, how many types of angles we learn? Right angle, acute angle, obtuse angle, straight angle. So four angles we learn. So what is called a right angle, children? The horizontal and vertical rays meet at a common point are called right angle. So this is horizontal and this is vertical. Okay, it forms a right angle. Okay, now I'm moving the hand to close to arm. It is smaller than right angle. Smaller than right angle means what? Acute angle. Okay, now I'm moving the hand to right side like this. Now it is bigger than right angle. Bigger than right angle is called obtuse angle. Now I'm moving the hand to like this, stretch. So it forms a straight angle. Did you understand, ma? Right angle, acute angle, obtuse angle, straight angle. Okay, ma'am. And next, so right angle, how can you represent right angle, children? How can you represent right angle? Suppose here two rays are drawn here, horizontal ray and vertical ray. It forms an angle. So you can represent right angle as with square. Which square you should represent? Okay, so you have to represent right angle with square. Four sides are equal, no? So square you should represent. But another angle, suppose I have to draw here. Okay, so here angle is formed. So this angle will be represent as arc. Represent as arc. Okay, so which angle it is? It is a smaller than right angle. So which angle it is? It is acute angle. Which angle it is? Acute angle. Acute angle can be represented as arc. And which angle it is? Right angle. Right angle can be represented as square. Okay, and next, another angle. Okay, it is bigger than right angle. Bigger than right angle also you should represent as arc. Sorry, bigger than right angle represent as arc. What do you call this angle, children? Obtuse angle. Obtuse angle. Obtuse angle. And next, another angle, what you learn? So this is one ray, this is another ray. It forms an angle. It is also represented as arc. So which angle is that? Straight angle. Which angle is that? Straight angle. Straight angle. Did you understand now? So right angle can be represented as square. Acute angle you can represent as arc. It is smaller than right angle. And obtuse angle also represent as arc. Okay ma? It is bigger than right angle. And next, straight angle. It is also represented as arc. Okay, did you understand now? So what do you learn? Types of angles today? Right angle, acute angle, obtuse angle, straight angle. Okay ma? Right angle means this one, horizontal ray and vertical ray meet at common point, forms a right angle. And next, acute angle means what? Smaller than right angle is called acute angle. And obtuse angle means bigger than right angle is called obtuse angle. Straight angle means it will be straight line. That is straight angle. Okay, ma? Did you understand? What are the types of angles? Right angle, the horizontal and vertical rays meet at a common point, form a right angle. Acute angle is smaller than right angle is called acute angle. Okay ma'am? Right angle. In your CW all of you write. Today homework is, children, open companion page number 10. Companion page number 10. Identify the angles as right, acute, obtuse or straight. One is done for you. Here some angles are drawn here. You have to identify which is obtuse, which is right, which is straight, which is acute. You have to find it. Okay. Acute. Here first angle is acute angle. Why? Because it is smaller than right angle. So it is acute angle. Like that you have to identify these angles you should write. Okay ma? What I told, right angle means what? Horizontal and vertical rays meet at a common point, forms a right angle. Straight like this. Okay. And acute angle means smaller than right angle. Like this. Smaller than right angle. Acute angle. And what do you call this angle? It is an obtuse angle. Bigger than right angle. And this is, it will look like straight. So it is a straight angle. Okay, children? This is the homework for you. Companion page number 10. You can identify the angles and write.